You've been watching too much Lion King.
You know. I'm just saying. We got a couple of those in our family. Two in mine, of course. You know, but all families need that. You know why they need that? Because those are the people that put you in proper perspective. Those that want to say, they say, you know what? Yeah, while I'm trying to act high and mighty, guess what? The same person that grew up with me, still rolling with me, and, you know, he's still good.
Mm-hmm.
This ain't no high and mighty type thing.
Mm-hmm.
It is what it is, and you just roll with it the way it is.
Mm-hmm.
And then you are happy because that same person that you thought was going to die at 20-something, still living at 60-something.
Okay.
And they can tell you how they got over. If it was getting over.
If it was. Okay.
Or they'll tell you how you thought they was black sheep, but they really wasn't. They was taking care of their business. Next thing you know, that one that you thought was going to be out there, he the one who got the most money.
Hmm. So every family has a black sheep.
I think so too, but who's the black sheep? Is it the straight and narrow or is it crooked?
Hmm.
Based off the Bible,
mm-hmm.
It's the crooked.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you why.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Bible says narrow is the road less traveled.
Right.
The family is going off the bigger road.
Mm-hmm.
But the one that's less traveled is the road you need to go to.
Mm-hmm.
Many are called, many are chosen, many are called, few are chosen. God is going to pick that one that mm-hmm. you never thought of.
Mm-hmm.
Moses would be the black sheep of the family because he killed somebody.
He sure did.
You know, Paul would be the black sheep of anybody's family, but God chooses black sheep.
Mm-hmm.
That's why if you want to call me the black sheep, I'll be blacker than black. That's
wow. Hey, boy, that's a bench woman for you.
Hey, you know, I gotta say it the way it is, right?
It is what it is.
I gotta come with it the way I gotta, and that's just what it is.
Yeah.
That's just how I am and who I am. That's just how I am and who I am. All right, so we gonna get off.
Okay.
And when we come back, we're going to get into some... I want to talk about some Heisman Trophy talk. I want to do Heisman Trophy talk.
To what extent?
Well, people are really good at about, you know, the Heisman Trophy period, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you want to list some good Heisman, some great Heisman Trophy winners. Like Barry Sanders. That was a great Heisman Trophy winner.
Mm-hmm.
I want to talk to the bust. I want to talk about the bust. The Heisman Trophy winners that should have been good.
That wasn't good when it got to the NFL?
Right.
Now that's a good one. All right. You listen to 411 Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com. Our website is 411SportsNews.com. We'll be right back.
Family.
Oh yeah.
A closing. Just my imagination. Once again, running away with me. I tell you it was just my imagination. Running
slow it down a little bit.
Why do you have to slow it down?
Because I was thinking. It was just my imagination.
Welcome back to 411 Sports Talk Radio, and this is Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com.
Wait, what'd you say? And this is Sports Talk Radio?
Yes, this is, considering what you just said, I got to remind the audience, this is Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com. Our website is 411SportsNews.com. If you want to, I'm finna say Twitter us. If you want to tweet us.
If you want to Twitter us. How do you Twitter somebody?
It is at 411 Sports DFW.
I'm messing with you.
That is the bench warmer who had to slow it down because he said he was in the moment. He was. Because
it was just my imagination. It was just running away from me. I tell you, it was just my imagination just running away from me.
All right, bench warmer. What's on the agenda, sir?
Okay, I want to do some Heisman talk.
And by the way, before we do that, we have a trivia question I want to put out there for the audience. Since 1982, only two players, I repeat, two. Since 1982, only two NBA players have won back-to-back Sixth Man of the Year awards. Name those players. I'm going to give you a hint. One of them played for the Indiana Pacers.
And the Mavericks.
Well, he said that, and the Mavericks. Again, trivia question. Since 1982, only two NBA players have won back-to-back Sixth Man of the Year awards. Name them. If you have them, call us. 844-432-2384, or leave your comment on our Twitter. I'm going to say Twitter again. Twitter
tweet
page.
Twitter us.
Or you can go to our Facebook page, which is 411 Sports, right?
That is right.
411 Sports
news.
Is our face.
Yep.
You got his news?
No.
Is it just 411 Sports, I think?
Yes, 411 Sports.
411 Sports is our Facebook page. Leave your answer on that page, or you can tweet us, or you can call us, or you can even email us if you like. Is that fine?
That is fine. What's your email address? info@411sportsnews.com.
Whoa, say that again.
What's your email address?
My email
address. Yeah, don't email me, because I don't need no.
You see how private benchwoman is? He want nobody emailing him. My email is sportsradiodj@411sportsnews.com. Again, that's Sports Radio DJ at 411sportsnews.com. I'll let the bench warmer, if he wants to volunteer, to his email, but you can tell he's keeping it private over here.
For some reason or another. You can send it to me. I'm at clions@411sportsnews.com.
Now you just told everybody your last name.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Email me at benchwarmer@411sportsnews.com.
You the main one to want nobody to know your last name.
Because I'm wondering.
Now everybody know.
It just went up to 14 states yesterday.
Well, anyway, if you have an answer to the question, let us know. We want to see if you really know some NBA trivia. Let's talk Heisman Trophy winners.
And losers.
Why they're losers?
Well, because I'm going to tell you why they're losers.
Okay.
Okay. So the Heisman Trophy is the top echelon of all trophies in high school, in college, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's supposed to be the number one trophy you can win in college. And it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's a prestigious thing to receive a Heisman Trophy. Because what that normally says is that if you receive a Heisman Trophy, that would most likely mean that your career in the NFL is going to have some star-studded things happening to it. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, I would agree.
I mean, you know, you're a Heisman Trophy winner. You're supposed to be it, right?
Right.
You're what they call the shiznick in college.
Okay.
We have to figure that word out later on. So let's go with some past Heisman Trophy winners, but I want to do something different. I want to talk about the Heisman bust. These are players that won the Heisman Trophy and didn't mount a jack in college and in the pros.
Okay.
So a Barry Sanders would not be considered a Heisman bust. He won the Heisman Trophy back in 1988. Tim Brown, the newly elected Hall of Famer, would not be considered a Heisman bust. But there's one player just after 1987 and 1988 who was a Heisman bust.
Mm-hmm.
Andre Ware.
Oh, my goodness.
Out of Houston. Went to Detroit.
Goodness. Let me tell you something. Okay. Andre Ware. And I want to say David Klingler.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. But David Klingler didn't win the Heisman.
Okay. Andre Ware won the Heisman, setting all kind of school records at the University of Houston. But he ran the run-and-shoot offense.
There's your problem.
At the University of Houston. He gets to the NFL. He was drafted by Detroit.
Yeah, he drafted. Yeah.
Now I can't remember if they already had the running shit installed
there
because they had Rodney Pete to run that offense.
Yep.
So I'm not sure if Andre Ware, when they drafted him, still had that offense installed.
Yeah, they had the offense. They had the offense, but the problem was
you got
Rodney Pete there too. So and the run and shoot wasn't necessarily a run and shoot. It was a walk and pop. It wasn't the offense that people thought it was supposed to be. So, I mean, but he had some gaudy numbers in college. Great numbers in college. But it just did not transform itself to the NFL. Give you another one.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Winkie.
Goodness gracious.
Out of Florida State.
Oh, my God. Man, I tell you, you bring us some good busts. Chris Winkie, he ended up playing for Carolina, I think.
Right, right.
And he was at best a backup quarterback.
See, his thing was this right here. He was old already. He came to the NFL old. Okay, remember he was 25 when he went to when he went to Florida.
Mm-hmm.
So he came to the NFL old anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And then he did win the Heisman. I mean, but that's about all he had. He was out of gas after he got into the NFL.
Okay.
Ready for another one?
Sure.
Tim Tebow.
Not yet.
No, is a Heisman bust.
No,
yes, he is a Heisman bust.
No, not yet. The man is not out of football.
What do you mean? Yes, he is. He's gone. No. Tim Tebow. Tim Tebow
is... He's not out the NFL. Okay. No one is picking him up.
Exactly. Why do you think that is?
That's what I'm saying. He's not... Now, no, Chris Winkie and Andre Ware, they're out of football.
Wait. Your responsibility as a quarterback is to get somebody the ball. If I can't throw somebody the ball, I am a bust as a quarterback. He can't throw. He overthrew.